Message begins right now. Beloved masters, you cannot even begin to imagine what magnificent beings you are, and the miraculous gift that was bestowed upon you when the Supreme Creator sent forth the command to the infinite facets of itself to go forth and create new worlds without end in my name. You have experienced the ebb and flow of creation many times beyond your comprehension over the past eons. You went forth in great anticipation upon receiving each new assignment, even as you eagerly looked forward to returning to your point of embarkation, or the seat of power from which you departed. An integral part of your mission has always been to earn the gift of life that was conferred upon you as you went forth to perfect your skills as a co-creator god of light. How could you appreciate and yearn for the light and your inherent state of perfection if you have never experienced the shadow lands and the distortions of human miscreation? Would you treasure the balance, peace, joy and harmony you have or will attain in your life if you had never experienced any turbulence, pain or suffering from the challenges of lack, limitation and the imperfections you brought forth to correct or accept? Would you feel the urge to grow, expand and create anew if you were always given everything you could ever desire? Each time you incarnated, you were encoded with a new soul mission, which included an intense desire to create new and wondrous things, and to experience and perfect new talents. You were also infused with all the attributes, qualities and virtues you would need to accomplish your mission. However, for the most part, these jewels of higher consciousness were buried deep within your sacred heart core and within the light packets of wisdom stored within your brain structure. No matter your station in life or your present level of awareness, it is time to end the game of hide and seek. You have hidden your talents and your many gifts from yourselves long enough, and for many lifetimes and much of this life's experience, most of you have been seeking relief and empowerment in all the wrong places. Beloveds, what you are seeking is not out there. It is within. What a clever place to hide your divine birthright and the treasures you seek. You have always known where your strength and power lie. You have always known that you carry the keys to the kingdom with you everywhere you go, no matter how far you journey into the unknown. However, you agreed to have the veil of forgetfulness drawn across your memory so that you could start fresh and be totally involved and focused on the new challenges and opportunities offered to you in order to further perfect your skills as a co-creator. See yourself sending out beams of light in an infinity sign, creating concentric circles around you filled with your specific intentions. You must be sure your intentions are aligned with your highest good and the greatest good for all. For you are creating an environment filled with the frequency patterns of your own making, and it is a universal law that you must always experience that which you create. Each of you has played a role in creating the distortions and imperfections of the world as you now know it, and each of you must take an active part in correcting the imbalances and returning the third, fourth dimensions to their original balanced, harmonious state so that all levels of creation may move upward on the spiral of enlightenment. If you do not clear up or rectify what you have created in this lifetime, you will have to do it in a future experience. You are not judged and have never been judged for the mistakes and miscreations you have made. However, you are held responsible for healing and balancing the past, and you have been given the tools to do so with ease and grace. We do not wish for you to suffer, and the divine plan does not call for you to be punished for your shortcomings. However, the rules of cause and effect still apply, although with some new modifications. You now have access to more cosmic information than you have had since you first incarnated into the physical expression. You now have access to the multiple levels of your vaster self and the full empowerment of your God self as you clear the inharmonious frequency patterns within and make yourselves suitable receptacles for the infusions of refined creator light. You now have full access to the blessed violet flame, which will assist you in transmuting and neutralizing all discordant energies, past, present and any future distorted timelines, as well as any probable futures you have created. You now have access to all the virtues, attributes and qualities of the three God rays at our universal level of empowerment. The first ray of divine will and power, that came forth from the golden ray of the Further Creator, and which carried all the seed thoughts of new creation. It is often called the ray of the first cause and is more mental in nature, a forward thrusting energy with a desire to expand and create anew. The cosmic second ray is the silver ray of the Mother Creator, the cosmic incubator of all creation at the omniversal level. It is primarily an emotional ray bearing predominantly the love spectrum of light, and is more inward focused with the desire to nurture the seeds of new creation and bring them to fruition. It is the second ray of love, wisdom within this universal experience. Together the gold and silver rays created the third ray, which has been designated as the sun ray, or the sun and daughter ray. At our universal level the third ray carries the impulses of active intelligence and the desire to be co-creators and manifest new worlds in the realms of physicality. In this universal experience, you had to choose which ray would be your overlighting ray or your God ray, the first, second or third ray, and you have been overlighted with that ray and its attributes and qualities in all your many incarnations. That rule has now changed. You are now in the process of integrating all of the qualities, virtues and attributes of all the 12 major rays of this universal experience, which include the three God rays, and as you move upward on the spiral of ascension, new rays of experience will be forthcoming as new abilities, gifts and qualities of God consciousness are made available. It has been mandated that, along with the blazing violet flame of transformation, it is now time to reactivate the first ray of divine will to its full power as it was when it was radiated forth from our Father, Mother God when this universe was created. It is a gift many of you have earned, but use it wisely, beloveds, for never again will you be allowed to use its magnificent qualities in a negative manner. Ask that you be guided to use it wisely and with the purest intention. The activation of the first ray of divine will and power will give you access to the dynamic attributes or strength, courage, valor, steadfastness, truthfulness and the ability to take control of your life as a co-creative bearer of light. Beloved bearers of light, each time, before you embodied in a new physical vessel, we gave you a symbolic sword, my sword of divine will, truth, and valor. We instructed you to use this sword to help you reclaim your mastery, and to sever any discordant energies that were keeping you shackled to the distortions and illusion of the lower dimensions. We ask you to reclaim your symbolic wings, beloved ones, come. Soar with us. Accept the gift of divine will and power we offer you as you strive to reclaim your proper station as a co-creative master of light. Once more, it is time that the first ray of divine will and power to create be made available to you, my brave warriors, as you reclaim your rightful place in my legions of light. When you, as divine sparks of the Creator, answered the first clarion call in this, a new universal experience, I promise to be with each of you throughout your long and arduous journey into the physical worlds of manifestation, for my main purpose has always been to guide, guard, inspire and protect you. My sword of flame blazed forth from my heart center, forged from pure Creator light. I knew there would be many times in your long sojourn throughout this universe when you would require more than the power you carried within to cut yourselves free from the shackles of miscreation in which you had become entangled. This sword is charged with my eternal love for you, my love for our Father, Mother God and the Supreme Creator. It is called the Sword of Truth and Redemption. It is not a sword of which to be frightened, and it bears the attributes or strength, power and valor for those who wield it truly and honorably. Take up this sword, my beloveds, and wield it with integrity, truth and valor. I ignite and blaze forth across your breast the insignia of the threefold flame, the golden flame of divine wisdom, the brilliant blue flame of power and will from our Father God, and the iridescent pink flame of love and compassion, the feminine aspect brought forth by our Mother God. My brave warriors, I ask you to set your hearts free from the bonds of fear, hate, and limitation. Embrace the spiritual freedom that is being offered you so that you may soar beyond the confines of time and space. Come, I will guide and assist you as I have in the past. I am Archangel Michael. If you are ready for this profound gift and initiation into the order of Archangel Michael and his legions of light, please read and declare this statement. I acknowledge my divinity. I accept my divine birthright as a co-creator with our Father, Mother God and the Supreme Creator to assist in the manifestation of heaven on earth. I accept the sword of Archangel Michael as a symbol of my worthiness. I promise to wield the energies of the first ray of power, will and authority with love and compassion for the greatest good of all creation. Sacred flame from the very heart of God, blaze in, through and around every electron of precious cosmic energy I have ever released or manifested which is less than perfection. Transmute now, cause, core, record and memory of every thought, word, action or feeling I have ever expressed which prevents me from knowing and accepting my true identity as a divine extension of our Father, Mother God. I ask that the violet flame of forgiveness blaze through and around me now and henceforth, expanding moment to moment to the maximum that cosmic law will allow, until I am free from every belief which is less than the reality of my perfect God nature. I am the presence of God made manifest in the physical world of form, and I accept my divine birthright and my mission now. So be it. So it is. I am that I am. Remember what we have told you, the ascension process is an ongoing journey, not a destination. Each day, endeavor to make the highest choices, staying in the moment, for that is the only time you can access your God power, not in the past and not projecting into the future, but seeking your highest potential in each and every moment. See the challenges and tests in your life as opportunities to expand and grow in awareness as you learn to let go of old self-limiting ways. Strive to maintain an attitude of gratitude for all the blessings in your life, both large and small, and watch as the goodness and lightness around you magnifies and expands day by day. During these challenging times of great change, each of you can make a difference. The changes which are needed to bring about balance and harmony in your world must begin with you. Beloveds, shine your love, light for all to see. Allow us to assist you to fulfill your mission and nurture you with our love. I am Archangel Michael. End of the message. Much love to all you soul sisters, brothers. Watch my previous videos for better understanding. New subscribers will be updated with the latest articles and informations. We hope this channel has helped you discover where to start on your actual spiritual path. It's a good karma to put to like, comment, subscribe and share with your beloved ones. Leave your suggestion in the field below. All the love to you, beautiful souls.